Eugene Normandy conducting the Philadelphia Orchestra in the Manfred Symphony by Peter Tchaikovsky. WVCA 104.9 megahertz in Gloucester, Massachusetts. Everyone's concerned with good health and nutrition. Combine them with great taste and you have fresh citrus. Orchid Island citrus from Kennedy Groves in Vero Beach, Florida. High in vitamin A, vitamin C, calcium, fiber, and potassium. Weight watchers love Kennedy's Orchid Island grapefruit, only 37 calories a half. A wholesome, nutritious gift of Kennedy's Orchid Island grapefruit or Indian River Naval oranges for an entire family delivered to your door, only $34.95. Get Kennedy Groves free catalog by calling 800-327-4768. Kennedy's toll-free lines will be in operation 8 in the morning to 5 in the afternoon, 7 days a week during their busy season. Kennedy Groves is the only Florida gift fruit shipper who owns groves on Orchid Island. A member of the Kennedy family is in their groves every day to ensure complete quality control. I'll be getting regular shipments of Kennedy's Orchid Island grapefruit, big juicy Indian River Naval oranges, and extra sweet tangerines delivered right to my home. Call for your free catalog, 800-327-4768. Kennedy Groves, Vero Beach, Florida. The Kennedy Groves watch line is open now, beginning at 7:30 in the morning. The quartet, number 17 in B-flat, Kirchner listing 458, by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, performed by the Juilliard String Quartet. In B-flat major, Kirchner listing 458 by Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, performed by the Juilliard String Quartet. It's now time to talk about contributions, but first to talk about Grand Bank. They're in court trying to extract the license from me. I don't think they'll be lucky enough to do it, but they're trying their best, as they have been since 1975. And the only thing that might give them a chance, the only chance I might have, is if they can raise a financial qualification issue and prove it. So therefore, I'm urging everyone who possibly can, who has not done so in 6 months or more, to make a special effort to contribute now by mailing cash, check, or a money order to WV as in Victor, WVCA, 50 Maplewood Avenue, Gloucester, Massachusetts, 01930. It is very, very important. And today my thanks go out to seven contributors. A check from, I believe, Linfield. There's no indication on the check from where it came. And a check from Marblehead. A check from Boston. Also from Swampscott 1, from Cambridge 1, and from Rockport 1. Six checks and a good-sized cash contribution from Linfield. So today there were 7 contributions in all. My deepest thanks to each and every one of these contributors. And if you wish to join them, you may do so by mailing your cash check or money order to WV as in Victor, WVCA, 50 Maplewood Avenue, Gloucester, Massachusetts, 01930. And now, a few words on another subject. And the other subject is this problem I'm having with interference, which caused me to let you know last week, the early part of the week, that I would be curtailing my operation. I won't be curtailing my hours. The hours will remain the same. On Sundays, they will be from 8 in the morning till 10 at night or thereabouts, sometime between 9 and 10. On Monday through Thursday, they will be 6 in the morning until 10 o'clock at night. On Friday, from 6 in the morning until 12 midnight. On Saturday, from 8 in the morning till 12 midnight. That's the current schedule, and that'll continue. And the reason I've decided to continue the schedule is that yesterday I received a copy of a letter that had been mailed to Whale of the Wash laundromat down below me here on the bottom floor of this building. And the letter said, "This office has received a complaint from Simon Geller concerning interference to broadcast monitoring equipment and amateur radio operation allegedly caused by the operation of neon signs. Enclosed are copies of the rules and regulations regarding incidental radiation, Volume 2, Section 15.4C and 15.25. Pursuant to these regulations, you are required to remedy the problem and report your results to this office within 15 days of receipt of this letter." So it looks like the FCC is in on the act now, and I think I'll get some results. They don't like it when somebody interferes with a station to the extent that the station can't fulfill its legal obligations under the rules. And that's what's been happening here. I'm unable to properly measure the output of the station here because of the interference from Whale of the Wash neon signs. So that's the way it stands now. I'm sure I'll get some results from FCC. It may take a little longer than I would like, but this should take it about 2 to 3 weeks. Because I'm not certain whether they, when they talk about 15 days, they mean 15 business days of Monday through Friday, or 15 calendar days. I hope it's 15 calendar days, but I can't be sure. And one of their people came up, stormed up here yesterday afternoon around just before 5 o'clock and told me as a result of this incident I would lose my license and threatened me with every consequence, every dire consequence you can think of. But still, I intend to proceed with this thing. I intend to go the limit to get that interference eliminated, to have that interference eliminated so I can operate legally and not fear a confrontation with the FCC. Because I have enough problems with the FCC over the past 10 years, I don't want any more due to something that's beyond my control and that can be remedied very simply. So that's the situation. I've said my piece. Now let's get back to the music. WVCA 104.9 megahertz in Gloucester, Massachusetts. Philippe Entremont at the piano, with a Philadelphia orchestra on the Eugene Normandy in the Concerto No. 2 in A major by Franz Liszt.